It's time for Business News with Richard Southern, and we begin with the Toronto housing market, which could finally be cooling down, Richard.
Yeah, are there cracks forming in the hot housing market? Maybe, Erica. We got the June numbers in today, and it showed that the fewest number of homes traded hands in June compared to any other time in the past year. 11,106 homes were resold in the GTA last month. That's down 7% over May. It's not clear what the exact reasons may be, although June was the first month under the federal government's stricter mortgage stress tests. Prices certainly still elevated. The average selling price last month, $1,089,000. That's up 17% over last June, but down 2% over May. Condos, which took a hit through the pandemic, are heating up again. Condo sales gained 4%, the average price above $683,000. Experts think the housing market will end the year strong. We'll have a big second half. Some agents are reporting, Erica, that they have calls from newly landed immigrants waiting to finish up their quarantine and eager to search for a home. The Toronto Regional Real Estate Board thinks the average price come the end of the year will be above $1,070,000. So don't count the GTA market out just yet.
All right, a major restaurant chain is trying to convince customers to start eating fresh again.
Subway sandwiches, Erica, trying to revamp its image. You know, they had that sort of healthy thing going a while back.
Yep.
Now maybe you don't necessarily, some people don't necessarily see it as being that way. Certainly, it seems the company is trying to get that healthy image back. Subway today announced that it's implementing its biggest change in its more than half century history, calling it the Eat Fresh Refresh. Subway rolling out new bread recipes for its Italian and multi-grain loaves, as well as new sandwich toppings. Upscale things, Erica, like smashed avocado and fresh mozzarella. The bacon will be hickory smoked. The steak will have new seasoning, and there'll be new vegan patty options. Again, experts say trying to get a more healthy, fresh feel going here. Subway's a privately held company, so we don't know what their sales stats are. Some estimates, though, say sales may have fallen 18% over the past year. So there's the big changes coming to Subway.
And yesterday, we talked about how cough medicine is flying off store shelves in countries where lockdown restrictions have been eased. But that's not the only product that's seeing a sales spike, Richard.
Yeah, interesting. Gum, chewing gum sales starting to heat up now, Erica.
That makes sense. All right. People taking
You know why that might be, right?
Yeah.
We weren't seeing each other face to face, didn't have to worry about the bad breath so much during the pandemic. And as a result, gum sales that were way down over the past year and a half. But now they're starting to heat up again. Bloomberg News reports that Americans purchased 15 million more packs of chewing gum in May than they did in January. Mondelez, which is one of the big producers, they make Trident, among other things. They say 75% of gum is chewed outside of the home, not only to beat bad breath, but also to beat boredom on public transit and in the car and so forth. So certainly another sign there, Erica, that as restrictions ease and we get back to normal, we're looking for gum.
We all got a whiff of our own breath wearing those masks, didn't we? So now we're just more aware of it, right?
Boy, I really should have laid off the onions tonight, you know? Boy.